So how did Santiago become such an incredible scientist? It wasn't easy. We don't have a picture of Santiago as a teenager, but we do have him as a university student. One of Santiago's hands is always hidden in the photos he took of himself because he's the one pressing the button to take the picture. Santiago took one of the world's first selfies. Santiago's dad realized his son needed a different approach. His dad decided to show him what real bodies look like to encourage him to become a doctor. Being able to see, touch, and draw what he was learning about fueled Santiago's interest. He went back to learn the math and science he missed when he was a boy. This time, he paid attention. He worked hard to build the mouse paths he hadn't built when he was younger. Santiago wondered whether neurons can change when you learn, whether learning can upgrade the brain.
So, we have to stop here and ask you a question. Wouldn't you love to get an upgrade on your brain? Your brain links tightened? It turns out you get this upgrade every single day, or I should say, every night. Let's explore this for a few moments, and then I promise we'll return to Santiago.
When you learn something new during the day, the buds of tiny new dendritic spines begin to peek out from your dendrites. They really bust loose and grow, especially when you're sleeping. These new grown-up dendritic spines form connections with the axons of other neurons at synapses. Wow! This means that brain links are made while you're asleep.
When you're sleeping, your brain practices what it's learned during the day. We can see those electrical signals traveling again and again through the same sets of neurons. It's as if, while we're dreaming, the space aliens have a chance to pass along some friendly, reassuring shocks over and over again. Another way to think of it is that during the night, your little mental mouse has a chance to run again and again along the neural pathway. Mice like to run around at night, remember. It's the nighttime practice during sleep that allows dendritic spines to get bigger.
When the dendritic spine grows big, the synapses get stronger. That is, the space alien can send a more powerful shock, and your brain links get a tiny bit stronger. This makes it easier to think about what you're learning. It's like walking on a nice, wide, smooth path instead of trying to push your way through the weeds and bushes.
Incidentally, just watching this video, if you're focusing, that is helping new dendritic spines to form. Your brain is changing when you learn. Dendritic spines are like little lie detectors. The new spines and their synapses only begin to grow if you're really focusing on the new information you want to learn. Dendritic spines can't be fooled. They can tell whether you've been playing video games or texting your friends instead of doing your homework.
But it's important to realize that even after you've started to learn something and bring new dendritic spines to life, the spines will wilt and disappear if you don't use them to practice. Your synaptic janitor removes these dendritic spines because they're not being used. Use them or lose them.
Have you ever understood something in class, but a few days later, when you looked again at your notes, found yourself lost? This is because your synaptic janitors cleaned away the budding dendritic spines. After all, they weren't being used. To prevent this from happening, look over your notes as soon as you've made them. Explain the ideas to a friend. Make flashcards. Remember, brief practice sessions over several days are much better than one long practice session.
Learning grows in your brain, sort of like brick walls. Gradual layers, day by day. Learn and sleep. Learn and sleep. Practicing over several days allows for the new synaptic links to get stronger and helps the new learning really take hold. If you try to cram, your neural mortar doesn't have a chance to dry. It's poor foundation for learning. Practice helps make permanent, or at least a lot stronger. Next, we're on to the value of metaphors, one of the most enjoyable parts of learning. Then, to finish the story of Santiago.
I'm Barb Oakley.
I'm Greg Hammonds.
And I'm Terry Sinofsky.
We and Arizona State University wish you happy learning.